Hello, I have bought a new automatic watch by the name of Pagani Design 1752. I ordered it on AliExpress. It's an online retail service based in China. The delivery took 18 days. Let's unbox this wristwatch. The watch comes in a blue paper box, and this is the Pagani Design logo. I paid $69.32 for this watch, including shipping. And now I want to see what's inside this box. This is a branded microfiber cloth. And here's the hang tag. The user's manual. That's it. So here it is, the visually spectacular Pagani Design 1752. It's a truly remarkable timepiece. This watch has grace and it's handsomely finished. Pagani Design is a homage brand, meaning an imitation of another more luxurious brand. This is not my first Pagani Design. I also have the Pagani Design 1692. Let's set the correct time on this one. This watch has a screw down crown, as it is 100 meters water resistant. In order to fire up this watch, you have to bang it quite hard. Now it's stopped. This watch displays both the date and the day. Today is Thursday, April 18th. This is an automatic watch, but you can also hand wind it. I unscrew the crown and I wind it by hand. So this watch is hackable, meaning that you can stop the second hand by pulling out the crown, like so. The crown is quite small. The crown is signed with the Pagani logo. But as this is a small watch, it has a small crown compared to the Pagani design 1692. The Pagani design 1752 is a homage to the much more expensive Rolex Day-Date Precedent with the 36mm dial, a watch that costs no less than $40,000. You have to be well-to-do to spend that much on a watch.
Launched in 1956, the Day-Date was the first self-winding waterproof chronometer wristwatch to display, in addition to the date, the day of the week spelt out in full, in two separate windows. Instantly recognizable, the unique design of the watch has shaped its personality. At launch, the Day-Date was the only watch with a semicircular window at the 12 o'clock position, displaying the full day of the week.
The dial on this one has a unique design. The dial is dark blue with a white handset and white Roman numerals. There's a Cyclops lens over the date. And at 12 o'clock, there's a window for the day of the week spelt out in full. The dial is nicely sized at a reasonable 36 millimeters. The steel case measures 41 millimeters from lug tip to lug tip. The thickness of the case is 12 millimeters. The lug width is 20 millimeters. And here's the Casio Duro for comparison. The Pagani design 1752 has a sapphire glass designed to resist scratches. The glass is optimized with anti-reflective treatment, which means that it offers exceptional visibility in any lighting condition. So the glass is claimed to be scratch resistant, and I will not try to prove that. Some people may think that the day and date windows are eyesores on the dial and that the dial appears much more symmetrical without them. But I think both windows are nicely placed and they fulfill their function. The case is made of polished stainless steel finished to a gorgeous degree. Let's see how it wears on my 6¾-inch wrist. This is a really good looking piece with a dressy vibe. As you see, I have plenty of clearance on both sides. The lug tips are nowhere near the end of my wrist on either side. With a thickness of 12 millimeters, the watch sits well under the cuff. I think you can wear this iconic watch on a wrist as small as 5½ inches. The bracelet has solid steel links joined by screw-in pins. And there's a trigger release fold-over clasp. Press the twin triggers and it pops open. The bracelet has no sharp edges and there's not much play between the links. This bracelet does the job required. It's a solid bracelet that will last for a very long time. And there's a transparent screw-down case back, a so-called exhibition case back. As you can see, there's a lot of complexity crammed into this 38mm case. And the Pagani design is equipped with a Seagull ST16 movement.
The automatic self-winding movement ensures precise timekeeping without the need for manual winding.
In standard automatic mechanical watches, the time can vary by plus minus 10 seconds per day. Mechanical watches typically have an accuracy of plus minus 5 seconds per day. Some high-end mechanical watches can reach an accuracy of plus minus 3 seconds per day.
These are mechanical watches with the second hand moving forwards in fractions of a second, meaning that the second hand moves continuously. Quartz watches have a jumping second hand. Quartz watches use an electronic oscillator regulated by a quartz crystal to keep time. The quartz oscillator generates a very precise frequency signal, which is why quartz watches are more accurate than mechanical ones.
Let's weigh the watch. It weighs 137 grams with all the links. So I have sized the bracelet. As you see, I had to remove these links. I think that the Pagani design 1752 wears very well on my 6¾-inch wrist. It's a handsomely finished dress watch. It's a glorious piece. All things considered, the Pagani design 1752 features thoughtful details. I like the Roman numerals and the day and date windows. I don't like that you have to bang the watch in order to start it. And I don't like that there's no lume. I hope I did leave no stone unturned with this review. Please watch world reviews for watch reviews and more on YouTube.